Welcome to Unite Now, where we bring unity to you, wherever you are.
Hello. Welcome, everyone, and thank you for joining us today. It's great having the chance to deliver this presentation. And today, we're going to give an overview about Unity's upcoming service, Unity Cloud Content Delivery. My name is Arturo. I'm a games evangelist at Unity. And as always, if you want to keep the conversation about this or any other Unity-related topics going, feel free to reach out to me on Twitter. So let's start. These are the takeaways for today. I hope that you have fun, learn something, get excited about implementing cloud content delivery in your projects. But at the end of the presentation, you will know how to serve content to your users effectively and also be able to use the addressable asset system in Unity with cloud content delivery. We have a lot of things to cover today, but the agenda is pretty simple. Today, we will discuss the problems that we're solving with cloud content delivery, some technical details of cloud content delivery, how to implement cloud content delivery in your game's pipeline, and cloud content delivery and the addressable asset system, how they work together. So let's start. Let's start by analyzing some situations that we as game developers face. So we're developing a mobile game. What we want is to provide the player the smoothest experience to download our game. So we want to remove friction from those big initial downloads. So we release a lightweight version of our game, but you know, as our game needs videos, models, other extra assets, we offer those as additional downloads. Once they are needed, our player is already playing. Where should these assets live? That's the question. Another example is that in other platforms, it's very common to deliver episodic content, a new chapter in the game story, new playable characters, etc. Such as in this game, we made for PC, right? So we want to offer additional characters such as in-app purchases. In this case, the initial download might not be an issue. However, providing more content in a remote way that does not disrupt the player experience is key. And the question again is, where and how do we deliver that content for our game? Another example is if your game offers like new maps or seasonal content, you also need a way of storing and delivering it to your players. Just the new content without any need of downloading the entire game again. How do you reliably and securely deliver it? The answer is Unity Cloud Content Delivery. In the nutshell, it's an end-to-end content managing and enterprise content delivery network. And let's take a look. So this is how our solution works. We author our game in any game engine, in this case, it's Unity, and the only thing that you need to manage is to separate your downloadable content from your standalone player. So if you're using Unity, you can use the addressable assets package, and we will talk about those later. Then you package your content and upload it to CCD, either from the dashboard or the command line, and also you build your executable and distribute it. Once your players already have the game and they need the extra content, they simply have to fetch it from the cloud content delivery. Okay, so as a recap, cloud content delivery is a solution for managing and delivering 2D and 3D content, an engine agnostic solution with integration benefits for Unity users, a reliable, fully managed solution with support packages, and it's backed by a top CDN with an industry-leading number of points of presence. Before jumping into the implementation, let's take a look at some concepts on how CCD architecture works. First, we have the concept of a bucket. A bucket is a single context for publishing content. For instance, we can have a staging bucket, a development bucket, production bucket, and in each one of those buckets we have like its name, the description, and also from which other buckets we can accept promotions. So we will talk about this in a second. Then we have our release. A release is basically a snapshot of the entries contained within a bucket at a single point in time. So all the assets that you want to distribute, they are uploaded, and then those become a release, like a snapshot in time of those. Now, we talked about entries, and the entries are the assets, but when they are already part of this release, let's say, or this process. So an entry is basically a single piece of content within a bucket. Entries are versioned and have support for things like labels and metadata. Now, a batch. A batch is simply a mechanism to differentiate different releases within a bucket, basically to provide more flexibility on the client side. For example, requesting the latest release in a bucket, we can just request it using the latest batch, if we name that batch that way. A key component of CCD is the ability of having multiple buckets for different parts of our project. For example, we can have a development bucket to add new features, etc., then our staging bucket for QA, and finally the production bucket. Inside our buckets, we can move our releases around. This process is called a promotion. So imagine we're working on the development bucket and we're ready to create a release. So it's working, and we send that, or we promote that, to the staging bucket for Q&A, and then we promote that released to the production bucket, and we can assign the batch. So that's the release that our users can fetch. We will use this simple demo as an example. A mobile game similar to Clash Royale. We want our game to have additional characters, levels, etc. So we will add those via cloud content delivery. So how does this work? The first step is we have to create our project. So here is a dashboard. I have my project and I need to make sure that I download the command line interface. We have those for Mac, Windows, and Linux. In this case, I'm using Windows, so I download that one. Then just make sure that you take note of your API key, which is the one that we'll use to authenticate. So this is my command line interface, and I have to authenticate here. This is my API key. Now I'm logged in to start using CCD from within the command line interface. So I have these buckets over here. I have development and production. I want to create a new bucket and name it staging. I can add the name, or I have to add the name and a description on basically how it should be used. Then you need to start adding content. So you can add the content via the command line using an addressable profile or using an API. We're going to do this using the command line. So we already logged in. We need to configure the active bucket. So we use the config set bucket command. And now we're going to be actively working on that bucket that we just created. Then we need to synchronize the entries that we have at a certain path into the active bucket. So you can see here, I have my asset bundles on that path on my computer. So I simply sync the entries that are located in that specific direction. So I added those entries. The next step is to release a create out of those entries that we just added. So you can see that my entries, the ones that I just added, now became a new release, and this release is on my staging bucket. If I go to my staging bucket, I can go and take a look at releases. I just have one release right now. I can have more than one. Then this is the process to promote. I want to promote from staging to, let's say, production. And I can assign the batch to this release. Although I can do that later. So I successfully promoted my release from one bucket to the other. I'll go to production just to take a look. And This is the latest release that I did. It has the correct badge. And you can see if I go to badges, I have two badges. Those were for testing. I can edit them. Here in my production bucket, you can see that the latest content is that one, the first batch. I'm moving that from that bucket that I just, from that release that I just uploaded to that one that is kind of old, but that's the one that our players will be fetching content from. Now we already have our buckets. Everything is working. Everything is in place. The next thing is to fetch our assets. So if you're using, if you just want to grab the assets, you just need to request them, assembling a URL similar to these. So you have to add or append the project ID. Then you have to also change the bucket ID. And if you want to use the batch approach, you have to append the batch name to your URL. Also at the end, you can request each entry by name. In the case of addressables, there's a different approach and we will take a look at that in just 1 second. Okay. So we already talked about cloud content delivery, but now if you're using Unity, you can take the most out of the, of CCD if you are using the addressable asset system. And we will highlight here what addressables are and how to the connection with cloud content delivery. So the addressable asset system. The addressable asset system is a Unity editor and runtime asset management system that improves support for large production teams with complex live content delivery needs. So the first step is to install the package. So you do this by going to the package manager, you search for addressables and you install the package. In this case, I have it installed. I could update it, which is always recommended. The next step is to configure your groups. If you go to asset management addressables and open the groups tab, you can see that I already have my groups here. You can accommodate those the way that makes more sense for your project. However, just to understand what these groups are different collections or logical collections of assets that you can use to generate your bundles later. So for instance, here I have the archers with just towers and characters. I have also the mages and the warriors, and I can add more assets to each one of those groups. So let's take a look at the game in action. My game has a seasonal level, which is a snow version of my regular level. If I click play, you can see my game loaded and I can instantiate some objects that are locally. Then I click on lock and the addressable system is fetching the assets from a remote location. In this case, those extra assets are not bundled with my game. They were added via cloud content delivery to a remote server, and they are working just here for testing. That's where the groups are now making sense. Remember, we have the archers group. Now those assets are in a separate bundle and they are included in the build that my users are installing. However, the mages and the warriors, those are not bundled with my game. So once the player unlocks them or buys them, addressables is going to go to the cloud content delivery network and is going to fetch them for me. We have to configure the profiles. So basically that's where should addressables save or build my bundles and where should addressables fetch those bundles from. So in this case, I have multiple profiles. I'm using this one called UCD. So I'm going to open the profile and you can see here that I have multiple profiles, one for default, one for testing locally, and then lastly, the UCD one. I'm building to that path in my computer, but from where it says remote load path, that's the address that addressables is using to fetch my content from. And that's the URL that we created previously. A note about addressables is that the API is asynchronous. That means we don't know when, basically when we execute something like instantiate or load some assets, we have to do that assuming that the assets probably are not locally, are not available there. So that's why we're doing something like a messaging or subscription system. So we're saying, okay, load these assets with this label. And once you complete the loading, execute this this function. So this is how it works. If the assets are already available in disk, because previously we loaded them or something, then this is going to execute faster probably. If they are not, then probably we will need to go to the server and download them. But the cool thing is you don't have to worry about where those assets are. Now, the integration, you can see here, I have my batch with the green level. I change the batch. Now, when I launch Unity again, you can see that I'm not now loading the snow level. Okay, that was it. Hope you had fun. This was a short, quick presentation. But before you go, please sign up to join the pilot program for cloud content delivery, which is launching soon. And if you want to learn more about addressables, please go to the blog or to the forums, and the team will be happy to help you. Thank you.